In this video, I'm going to talk about one of the rarest and coolest house plant called as Philodendron Burlimax. Hello everyone, welcome back to Simply Shrija. You can see here a nice lush green house plant called as Philodendron Burlimax. It is one of the best house plant to own. This plant grows from one leaf to many leaves within few months. It's popular as it has such nice, glossy, beautiful looking foliage. Leaves are big, waxy and arrowhead shaped. It has a central vein that goes till the end of the leaf. Coming to the first point, that is pot size. I have this plant in a 9-inch pot, basically a grow bag. It has grown really well and I can take lot of cuttings from this plant as well so that I can have new plants. I will show in the end of the video how I have propagated many plants from this mother plant. The next point is sunlight. Coming to the sunlight, this can be grown in low light to bright indirect light. This plant gives out lot of aerial roots by which we can grow them or propagate them. As this plant is an aroid, aroid mix can be used, that is coconut coir, orchid bark or perlite mixture. It can also be grown in soil, garden soil plus cocopeat and perlite. Usually this philodendron can be grown in indoors with leca, that is semi-hydroponics. It can be propagated in water, leca semi-hydroponics and soil, cocopeat and perlite mixture or in sphagnum moss also. But the aerial roots can be grown into new roots very slowly in water. It takes lot of time, like more than 3 to 4 weeks to grow new roots in water. Definitely it grows very well in leca semi-hydroponics. And in soil, sometimes when you put these with the aerial roots, you can directly transplant them in soil, but it takes lot of time and some of the leaves can turn yellow or become yellowish over time, and new leaves will definitely come after some time. So you can keep them first initially in water and wait, have lot of patience for new roots to develop, and then you can transplant them into the soil or you can try leca balls. Here you can see how the aerial roots will look and where you have to take a cutting. Generally you have to have one or two aerial roots. Below that you can make a nick with a knife or a scissors, and then you can transplant them or you can keep them in water. I'm showing here the aerial roots. Just make a nick underneath this aerial root and then you will have a new plant. Aerial roots are very strong and generally if you just leave them like that, they will grow into the soil and they will branch out very nicely. If you give a moss stick into this pot, definitely these aerial roots will take over that moss stick and it will grow like a vine. It will really look beautiful. I will show all my propagated plants also. You can see this is my Burlimax station. I have them in smaller pots. You can see how nice the foliage has come out. At this point, I would like to mention about the railing planter also. Here I got this railing planter from Trust Basket. They are really sturdy and almost accommodate 4 of my Burlimax pots here. Coming to the next point, that is fertilizer. I generally prefer liquid fertilizer like seaweed solution once a month or once in 2 months. If you are a recurring subscriber here or a viewer, you would also know that I really like seaweed solution as fertilizer. I use seaweed solution on all my pothos and philodendrons. It really works well on all these varieties of plants. The next point I want to mention is about watering. Watering can be done inconsistently, that is like water only when the soil dries out very well, because these roots of this philodendron likes very good aeration, have a very well draining soil mixture. Otherwise it can go root rot and you will lose the plant. So make sure that you water it only when the soil dries out, or if you are in a very hot climate, maintain your regular watering schedule for this plant. You can see the aerial roots that are so long here, even when grown in very small pots also, you can see all the aerial roots. It's a very nice plant to propagate, and very easy to propagate basically, and the leaves really look very nice, as you can see here. This plant is named after Roberto Burle Marx. Burle Marx was one of the first architect to use this as a house plant in his architectural designs. It is also said that these plants remove toxins from the air around them, so it can be used as an indoor plant, but you have to have a grow light or indirect bright light, so this plant can be kept near a window. This plant is a tropical plant that originates from Brazil. If you want to keep it indoor, the humidity should match the tropical climate, so humidity is very important for this philodendron to thrive. It needs that moisture in the air. So you need to have a humidifier, or you can mist the leaves with water from a spray bottle, or you can keep few pebbles filled with water near this plant, or the next point is you can group some plants so that humidity is maintained. Coming to the last point, that is repotting. When we should repot this philodendron? We should repot when the roots will start to root bound, basically compact a lot and become like a ball. Then you can repot this. Before repotting, you can definitely have a lot of new plants by propagating, and you have to repot it to a new pot which is usually little bigger than the original, that is 2 to 3 inch bigger. Generally this plant is pest free. Sometimes mealybugs can attack this plant. So almost we have come to the end of this video. This is a plant that I have propagated directly in the soil. You can see the new leaves coming out. Hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I have given the necessary care tips for this plant. If you like this video, please share among your friends and family. Thanks for watching. Take care. Please consider subscribing to my channel if you are new here. I will see you in the next video. Bye.